Hi everyone, and welcome to the Zenduty onboarding guide. I'm Shivam from Zenduty's developer relations team, and I'm here to help you get familiarized with Zenduty's features along with some useful tips to get the most out of your account. In this video, we'll cover the basics of Zenduty, and over the next couple of videos, we'll show you how you can get your Zenduty account up and running within just a few minutes. So let's dive into it. So what's Zenduty, you may ask? Well, Zenduty is an end-to-end incident management platform that provides you real-time alerts from your production systems, including your monitoring, ticketing, and support channels. We help you manage those critical incidents, delegate crucial tasks effectively within your teams, minimize business impacting downtime, and at the end of the day, we help you meet your SLAs. So let's take a look at the structure that Zenduty provides. At the center of Zenduty is the account, an individual Zenduty tenant. Within the account, you can define multiple teams, completely depending on your organizational structure. Here you have three teams, an infra team, a back-end team, and a front-end team. Each team consists of a set of users, a set of services, set of on-call schedules, and escalation policies. You can also custom define your incident priorities, SLAs, your incident roles, tags, task templates, and a lot more. Each service within Zenduty now points to a specific component within your production infrastructure. So it can be a monitoring tool, it can be a particular region within your infra, it can even be a single microservice. The infra team here has a bunch of services, including an Azure service and a payment service. Each of these services are monitored by what we call as integrations. An integration is essentially an alert source. So it can be an integration with your APM or server monitoring tools or your support and ticketing systems. These integrations will send alerts to Zenduty, which will in turn create incidents according to the alert's urgency and predefined settings. The Azure service here is monitored through a couple of monitoring tools. So that includes Azure Monitor naturally and Datadog alerts. The Azure service here also has outgoing integrations with Slack and Jira. So whenever any new incidents come in within the service, it will send a message to a designated Slack channel and also create a Jira ticket with synchronized updates. Within the same infra team, you have custom P0 and P1 priorities defined to better classify incidents. We also have SLA thresholds for these P0 incidents, which have a resolution threshold of 30 minutes, and for P1 incidents with a resolution threshold of 24 hours. You have a couple of on-call schedules defined, assigning a user as a primary on-call user, a user as the on-call user for database issues, and an on-call user for application issues. The team also has a couple of escalation policies defined. You have an escalation policy for support and one for SREs. So whenever there is any issue within any of these services, they can be escalated through either of these two escalation policies. They've also defined incident roles and task templates, and these are concepts that we will cover in later videos. So let's take a look at how an incident is created within Zenduty. So you have an alert source, it's typically a monitoring system or a support application maybe. And whenever any of these tools detect any critical events, Zenduty will receive those signals from those tools and it will create something we call as an incident inside the associated service. Whenever an incident is created, it will execute an escalation policy, which is mapped to that specific service. When an escalation policy is executed, it will alert all users that are part of that escalation policy on their various defined communication channels, and the alert will be escalated depending on preset parameters. The on-call engineers will then go ahead and acknowledge the issue to prevent any further escalation of these incidents. And then finally, once the incident has been remediated, they will resolve the incident on Zenduty, and the same will reflect in any outgoing integrations. Let's take a quick view of Zenduty through a few screenshots that we have here. So the first concept is the concept of the team. You have the backend team, the customer care team, the Kubernetes team, the applications team, and a payments team configured in this particular account. The Kubernetes team here has about 7 members, and each of these members have defined their own contact methods or contact information, essentially prescribing which channels they could be alerted by Zenduty on. This includes email, you have SMS, phone calls, Slack, Microsoft Teams, Google Chat, and you have push notifications from our Android and iOS applications. The team also has a couple of on-call schedules defined. So here we have the day shift schedule, and in each schedule you can add as many users as you want, create multiple layers with varying shift lengths, and can restrict the schedule to specific times of the day or the week. You can also add an override, allowing a user to easily tap in for another user when they're unavailable, avoiding unnecessary hassle. And at the end, you can see what your schedule looks like. You can generate a daily, weekly, or monthly view and sync it with your Google calendars. The team also has defined escalation policies. So a typical escalation policy would basically involve a set of either individual or users or on-call schedules which can be notified at various stages of an incident. And you can repeat these cycles as many times as you want. The Kubernetes team has a few services inside the team which could signify a part of the operations that is owned, built, or maintained by the team. And for each service, you can associate a default escalation policy, a task template, an SLA policy, and a priority automatically assigned to incidents created inside this service. This service here is monitored by a bunch of integrations or alert sources, and you can choose from the likes of AWS CloudWatch, Datadog, Dynatrace, Grafana, New Relic, Sentry, Prometheus, Azure Monitoring, and maybe even a generic API integration for custom or internal sources. You can also choose from outgoing integrations like Jira, StatusPage, Slack, Zoom, and even send an outgoing email or a webhook whenever an incident is created or updated. Once an incident is created now, you will be able to view the incident within the Zenduty incident dashboard. Over here, you have a view of all the open incidents currently underway, and you can use filters to create a custom view of incidents relevant to you as of now, and even search for any incident, service, user, schedule, or even a team throughout the website via the global search on the top. And then finally, you have the main incident page, or the incident view if you may, wherein you'll be able to see concise details about each incident, who it is assigned to, what the associated escalation policy is, and the various communication channels linked like Zoom, Jira, Slack, and Teams. You'll also be able to see the alerts that created the incident, the timeline for the incident actions, any associated tasks, similar incidents, stakeholders, and notes right from this page. So looking at an overview of this video, we learned how Zenduty accounts consist of several teams. Each team in turn contains their own services, which hold the incoming integrations, that is the alert sources, and outgoing integrations, that is the comms channel, status pages, and much more. Incidents are created when incoming integrations like APM and support tools send alert to your Zenduty service. Each team also has schedules, which are the on-call rotations, and escalation policies, that is the order in which individual users and the on-call user for schedules will be notified. Every user maintains their own contact methods, that is the notification endpoints they wish to be alerted at. So this could be anything from SMS, email, calls, Slack, and reliable push notifications. And features like SLAs, priorities, task templates, roles, tags, and postmortems help your team respond to, manage, and learn from incidents much better. And that's all. I hope you found this video helpful in getting started with Zenduty. And in the next video, we'll show you how you can set up your contact methods in Zenduty and how you can customize your notification channels and your notification rules depending on the urgency of the incident.